edupedia.world.com. This is Somjaje Nair, your online biology tutor. The chapter is sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In the last video, we have discussed about the male reproductive structure of the flower, the androecium. In this video, we are going to discuss about gynoecium, the female reproductive part of the flower. Gynoecium. The gynoecium represents the female reproductive part of the flower. The gynoecium may consist of a single or multiple pistils. Each pistil has three parts, the stigma, style, and ovary. The stigma serves as a landing platform for pollen grains. The style is the elongated slender part beneath the stigma. The basal bulged part of the pistil is the ovary. The pistil consists of ovule bearing basic units called carpels. Collectively, the carpels form the gynoecium, which is sometimes referred to as the female part of the flower because the carpels produce the female gamete. This is a diagram of a pistil. Here you can see the style and the stigma and the ovary. Types of flowers based on carpels. A gynoecium may contain a single carpel, many separate carpels, or many carpels that have fused together. The gynoecium may consist of single pistil that are called monocapillary, or may have more than one pistil. They are called multicapillary. A monocarpous gynoecium is made up of only one carpel. This means that in the middle of a flower, there is only one stigma, one style, and one ovary. For example, the flowers that produce peach fruits are monocarpous in nature. The single ovule becomes the seed or pit of a peach, and the single ovary becomes the juicy fruit that you eat. When there are more than one, the pistils may be fused together, that are called syncarpous, or may be free. They are called apocarpous. Types of flowers based on carpel, the diagrammatic representation. The first one is a monocarpous gynoecium with one carpel. The second one is an apocarpous gynoecium with two separated carpels. The third one is a syncarpous gynoecium with only one ovary, that is, ovaries fused together. And the fourth one is syncarpous gynoecium with ovaries and styles fused. Here you can see a picture of apocarpous flower and syncarpous flower also. In apocarpous flower, they are free. So that's why you can see the pistils are free. And the syncarpous, it is fused together to form a bud. Comparison of gynoecium terminology using carpel and pistil. The first column, it is the gynoecium composition. The second one, carpel terminology. Third one, pistil terminology. And the last one, examples. If there is single carpel, it is called monocarpous or unicarpellate gynoecium. Then the pistil is the simple one. Example is avocado and most of the legumes. If there are multiple distinct, that is unfused carpels, they are called apocarpous or choricarpous gynoecium. The pistils are simple, for example strawberry, buttercup. The last one is multiple conate, that is fused carpels, that is called syncarpous gynoecium. Here the pistil is a compound one. The example is tulip flowers. Ovary. The basal bulged part of the pistil is the ovary. Inside the ovary is the ovarian cavity. That cavity is called locus. The placenta is located inside the ovarian cavity. Arising from the placenta are the megasporangia, that is commonly called as ovules. The number of ovules in an ovary may be one. For example, wheat, paddy, mango, etc. And too many, like papaya, watermelon, orchids have many ovules. Here you can see an example of an ovary with so many ovules. So in the fruit, there will be so many seeds. It will develop into so many seeds. we can divide the flowers according to the position of the ovary also. The position of the ovary differs in different plant species. If the ovary is attached above the attachment of other three whorls like the corolla, calyx and antrisium, the ovary is said to be the superior. That is called hypogynous. If it is below the level of attachment of the three whorls, it is inferior. Then it is called as epigynous. And the third possibility is the intermediate, that is the perigynous, where the ovary is superior but surrounded by a receptacle from which other three whorls sprout. This is the diagrammatic representation of hypogynous, perigynous and epigynous flower. Here the first one, that is A, it is a hypogynous. Here you can see the ovary is superior to other three whorls. The second one is a perigynous. Here it is in the intermediate position. The ovary is superior but it is surrounded by receptacle from which other three whorls are sprung. And the last one, the C, it is an epigynous. Here the ovary is below the level of the attachment of the other three whorls. Placentation. Based on placentation also we can divide the flower. The ovary may consist of one or more chambers or locules which contain one or more undeveloped seeds, the ovules. The area of the ovary wall where the ovules are attached is called the placenta. The arrangement of the placenta varies in different species. The types of placentation are A. Basal placentation, B. Apical placentation, C. Parietal placentation, D. Axial placentation, E. Central placentation and F. Marginal placentation. First one, basal placentation. Here the placenta is at the base or bottom of the ovary. It can be seen in a simple or compound carpel. Apical placentation. The placenta is the apex position or the top of the ovary. It is also seen in simple or compound carpels. Parietal placentation. It is found only in compound carpel. The ovary is positioned in the ovary wall within a non-sectioned ovary. The next one is axial placentation. The ovary in axial placentation is sectioned by radial spokes which placentas in separate locules. Axial placentation is seen in compound carpels. The next one is central placentation. This is also known as free placentation. Here the placenta are arranged in the central column within a non-sectioned ovary and is seen in compound carpels. Marginal placentation. It's a type of placentation. Is conspicuous in legumes and simple carpels. Here there is only one elongated placenta on one side of the ovary. This is the diagrammatic representation of different placentation. Here you can see the axial placentation. Here the ovary in axial placentation is sectioned by different radial spokes with placenta and it is separated locules. Next one is free central placentation. Here the placenta arranged in a central column within a non-sectioned ovary. The next one is parietal placentation. Here the ovary is positioned in the ovary wall with a non-sectioned ovary. Here you can see the placenta is in the ovary wall within the non-sectioned ovary. Marginal placentation. Here there is only one elongated placenta on one side of the ovary. Apical placentation. The placenta is in the top position. And the basal placentation. The placenta is the base of the bottom of the ovary. The megasporangium or ovule. The ovule is a small structure attached to the placenta by means of a stalk called funicle. The body of the ovule fuses with funicle in the region called hilum. Thus hilum represents the junction between the ovule and funicle. Each ovule has one or two protective envelopes called indigments. Indigments encircle the ovule except at the tip where a small opening called micropyle is organized. Opposite the micropylar end is the calyssa, representing the basal part of the ovule. Enclosed within the inducements is a mass of cells called the nucellus. The cells of the nucellus have abundant reserve food materials. Located in the nucellus is the embryo sac or female gametophyte. An ovule generally has a single embryo sac formed from a megaspore through reduction division. This is a diagrammatic view of a typical anatropous ovule. Here you can see the hilum. It is the junction between the ovule and funicle. The funicle is also there. This is a structure attached to the placenta by means of a stalk. And the body of the ovule fuses with the funicle. That is called hilum. And each ovule has one or two envelopes called inducments. Here you can see the outer inducment, inner inducment. A small opening at the tip of the inducment encircle is the micropyle. Here you can see the basal end, that is the chalazal end, it's the basal part of the ovule. And the mass of cells called nucellus is present inside. It have the food reserve. Then embryo sac is present inside the nucellus. Here there is only a single embryo sac is present. And the top part is the micropylar pole and the basal part, as I told, it is the chalazal pole. Megasporogenesis. The process of formation of megaspores from the megaspore mother cell is called megasporogenesis. Ovules generally differentiate a single megaspore mother cell, MMC, in the micropylar region of the nucellus, that is the top portion of the ovule. It is the largest cell containing dense cytoplasm and a prominent nucleus. The MMC undergoes meiotic division. Meiosis results in the production of 4 megaspores. Female gametophyte. In a majority of flowering plants, one of the megaspores is functional while the other 3 degenerate. Only the functional megaspore develops into the female gametophyte, that is the embryo sac. This method of embryo sac formation from a single megaspore is termed as monosporic development. This is a diagrammatic picture of megaspore. Here the part of the ovule showing large megaspore mother cell, that is the first one. Then with a dyad, that is a megaspore dyad. Here you can see the micropylar, it is a nucellus and megaspore dyad. And a tetrad, the last one is a tetrad. Here you can see megaspore tetrad. Formation of the embryo sac. The nucleus of the functional megaspore divides mitotically to form 2 nuclei which moves to the opposite poles, forming the 2 nucleate embryo sac. 2 more sequential mitotic nuclear division result in the formation of 4 nucleate and later the 8 nucleate stages of the embryo sac. Mitotic division are strictly free nuclear, that is the nuclear division are not followed immediately by cell wall formation. After the 8 nucleate stage, cell walls are laid down, leading to the organization of typical female gametophyte or the embryo sac. Here you can see the 8 celled stage, and after the you can see the mature embryo sac with synergids, eggs, 2 polar nucleus and antipodals. I'll explain this detailing. In the mature embryo sac, 6 of the 8 nuclei are surrounded by cell wall and organized into cells. The remaining 2 nuclei called polar nuclei are situated below the egg apparatus in the large central cell. 3 cells are grouped together at the micropylar end and constitute the egg apparatus. Here you can see the egg apparatus. The egg apparatus in turn consists of 2 synergids. Can see 2 synergids and 1 egg cell. The synergids have special cellular thickening on the micropylar tip called filiform apparatus, which play an important role in guiding the pollen tubes into the synergid. Three cells are at the chalazal end and are called the antipodals. The largest central cell, as mentioned earlier, has two polar nuclei. This is a typical angiosperm embryo sac at maturity, though 8 nuclei is a 7-celled stage. Thank you. In the next video, we will be discussing about pollination and fertilization in flowering plants.